There are some question answers, very interesting questions. Dear Swamiji, you just dropped a nuclear bomb on our consciousness by revealing naked truth in such a direct and simple way. Thank you very much for the blessing. Can we expect more such bombs in the next few days? Anand Maheshwara. Maheshwara, my very presence is constantly dropping bombs. Because you are sensitive, you got the bomb. Yesterday, whoever felt it's a bomb, you really opened up. If you think I'm just throwing stones, you are nothing but a stone. Still, you are old, dumb idiot. It will take long time. It's Ananda Maheshwara, hope of man. Your consciousness was ready. That's the reason you are able to feel, you are able to experience a nuclear bomb. Actually, it is a nuclear bomb. If you understand that one thing and internalize, your whole life, whatever you think as life, whatever you think as death, whatever you think, the whole thing will be revolutionized. Whole thing will be revolutionized. You will not be a same person again. Just a simple understanding will transform you, because whatever you think as your problem, the very root will disappear, because it is not there. You can't help it. If you think anger is your problem, it is not there. You are connecting and making thinking that you are a person with anger. If you think your sex is a big problem for you, it is not there. You are connecting your 10 years ago the sexual fantasy which appeared in you, 9 years ago the sexual fantasy which appeared in you, 1 month ago the fantasy which appeared in you. You are connecting it and making an idea that you are a man filled with sexual fantasies. And you are trying to fight with it. It is not there. You are just connecting things which is not there. An important thing, the moment you start thinking about something, you are tired of sexual fantasy. That means you are thinking about something. Be very clear. For example, you are thinking of sex. After 10 minutes, suddenly you are thinking of food. Means what? You renounce sex. That's why you are thinking about food. After 10 minutes, you are thinking about meditation. Means you renounce food. That's why you are thinking about meditation. The thought of food, the thought of sex, both are having same impact or effect on you at that moment. But later on, when you connect and start thinking, no, food is having only small impact, sex is having too big impact on me, you create a bubble. Somebody asked Krishnamurti, why is sex such a big trouble? Krishnamurti says, how much of time you spend for it? Hardly 15 minutes. I think that is too much time. Then Krishnamurti asks, how much of time you spend on the food? At least 1 hour per day. Because three times you eat, at least 1 hour. Then Dudley Jetty says, the thing which you take 1 hour per day doesn't affect your consciousness so much. But the thing which takes only 15 minutes a day affects your consciousness so much. Why? Because you connect and see. Constantly you connect and see. Your whole life, whatever you think as your problem, is purely your connections. You just connect and see. Whatever you think, and one more thing, if you think something is very juicy, or joy in your life, again the idea is, connecting and see. If you think it's a depression, you are a depressed guy, you are connecting and seeing. If you think you are a very intelligent, smart guy, you are connecting and seeing. If you think you are a dull, dumb idiot, the truth, you are connecting and seeing. Again, constantly you are connecting and seeing. Your whole understanding about your life is nothing but connection. Nothing but pure connection. What I said yesterday is a nuclear bomb of consciousness. I don't think, as far as I know, I have never heard this any other master speaking so openly, so bluntly, so straight away. I have never read in any book, or I have never seen any master speaking. I don't know about anything else, but one thing I can be sure, I think this is going to be one of the biggest gift, or the great gift to the planet Earth by me. You are completely liberated being. Every moment you connect and see things. You are connecting, everything. If you think the person who was sitting yesterday, the Swamiji was in front of you yesterday, the Swami is in front of you today, is same, again you are connecting. It's not same. The whole thing is just moving, be very clear. Yesterday some atoms have entered in me, and now some cells have died in me, and I am not same. I can't be same. Constantly things are moving. Constantly things are happening. That is why I say the whole world is verb, not noun. It is a happening. It is not noun, it is a verb. Be very clear. This Ananda Sabha is not a noun. This mall is not a noun, it is a verb. Constantly some atoms are entering into the structure, some are coming out of the structure. Because the speed is so intense, you see this as a solid object. Same way your body also. Constantly you are connecting things for the sake of understanding and generalization. Be very clear, when you generalize, the moment you generalize, you have committed the ultimate crime. Atmahatya dosha, or the original sin. Here, these 15 days, I am just going to make you live with this flowing. As on now, your mental structure is created only to live with the solid things. Only to live with the connection. The more connections you create, the more chains around you. If you create the maximum number of chains, you will be dead. You are dead. Be very clear. Most of you are 90% dead. Hardly 10% you are alive. That is why even when you laugh, you don't laugh with the whole body. Because there are chains. You can't see. I can see all the chains. You don't shake the muladhara area. When kids laugh, you can see first thing, they will shake the manipurana muladhara. First movement, just watch when kids laugh. The first moment, the wave will start in muladhara, start in manipurana. Before it comes to vishuddhi, it will penetrate the muladhara. Before the vishuddhi starts moving by laughter, the muladhara will be moving. First the wave will start in manipurana, the muladhara will move, only then the vishuddhi will move. In your case only vishuddhi will move. You will neither feel at manipurana nor at muladhara, because there are so many chains, so many connections, so many bandages. Constantly you connect and see. Your mind which you have now is created to live with the connections, connecting and seeing. In these 15 days, I am going to create a no mind in which you can just live spontaneously without connecting and seeing. I am just making, I am going comfortable with my state, the tremendous fear which raises in you will be just foolish, useless fear. This whole 15 days, my only work is wherever you are being insecure and cut, wherever you are not able to let go, with this understanding, I'll put my hand exactly on that and make you feel live with this eternal truth, Nitya Satya. You are unconnected, unattached, unclutched, illogical, causeless, uncontrollable being. Whatever you have is causeless, uncontrollable, illogical, and unconnected, independent thoughts. Let it be very clear. As Ananda Maheshwara says, I am revealing the naked truth in such a direct and straight, simple way because I have a hope at least few people will catch this truth. The moment you catch this truth, you are the blessing on the whole planet Earth. Be very clear. You are the salt of the planet Earth. That's the reason I am breaking the very grounds on which I built this institution. I am very clear, straight away I am telling you, healing is nothing but an illusion. Because you having a body is the first illusion. Then you create an illusion of disease. Then you acquire one more illusion that something touches I will heal because of so many data which you collected. So many people have experienced that. So that idea which you collected, you come with the both illusions. I support one illusion which will make you feel better. When this illusion is strong, suddenly you heal yourself. That's all. Be very clear. I'm going to the roots with only one idea. At least few of you will understand this truth. I'm courageously empowering all of you with this truth. There is a possibility that you can become God. That's the reason I'm empowering every being with this truth. You say, remember, you are here for transformation, not for knowledge. He said, the knowledge is a tool that can lead us to transformation. If so, how to be in knowledge, using knowledge but not trapped by the connected thoughts of mind. First thing, if the knowledge is a tool for transformation, you will not even feel it's a knowledge. Yesterday what I said, that is knowledge. You will not even feel it's a knowledge. Straight away to put you into transformation, that's all. But anything which says tomorrow I will transform you, today I am a knowledge, it's not knowledge. Be very clear. Whatever you think as knowledge enough, the real knowledge you will not be able to announce. What you can't pronounce is real knowledge. Whatever you can announce, better announce as early as possible. The moment you understand something as knowledge, throw the curry. Something will be working inside you without even you knowing it's a knowledge is knowledge. Don't bother with whatever you know as knowledge. Drop them. Drop them. That's the only way. Swamiji, your own life after enlightenment seems to be consistent and clutched. What drives this shaft that you are creating or have created? How is this different from the shafts we create? Nice question. First thing, our Ananda Prashanta has, Narayana has this question. First thing which you need to understand, you need to know 4-5 levels First thing, I am not late in Shanti. Never ever think I am consistent. If you leave around me, you will understand. Just ask the people who are living around me for one, any simple thing. Today will Swamiji come? Nothing can be told. All they know is nothing can be told. That's all. And not only about this, in no way I am having shy. But you cannot believe this because constantly you are creating a shaft about me. Because constantly you are creating a shaft about me, you think I am also having a shaft. All of you should know about this Paramahamsa story. Advaitananda Ramanathan asked me to give an introduction about biography. A small story to explain. So there are special kinds of swans on the sky. They lay the egg and it comes down. In the mid-air itself it will hatch. And after a few minutes it will grow wings. And the swan will never touch the ground, just it will fly. It will just fly and go back to the mother and start floating in the air itself. This is the story of Ramakrishna. Now I add further a little more. The swan was flying on the sky. Suddenly the reflection of the swan was seen on the pond. When all the fishes saw that reflection, they all started jumping. Some fishes said, "Oh, what beautiful fishes come. White fishes come. So nice." All the fishes have started jumping around the reflection. Some fishes have started making a fence around the reflection. "Hey, this is the ashram of the swan." Some fishes started getting hand close to the swan. Some fishes started selling the real estate, flats around the reflection. When the reflection was moving around the Los Angeles, all the Los Angeles fishes gathered and created ashram. When the reflection was moving around the France, all the body fishes gathered and created ashram. When the reflection moved around the Canada, all the Canada fishes started gathering around and created ashram. When the reflection moved around the Tamil Nadu, all the Salem fishes started gathering and creating an ashram. Suddenly Tamil Nadu fishes called, all fishes coming and will have international conference. And all the fishes all over the world came and started jumping. And this went, goes on. And some fishes, they jumped towards the swan, towards the reflection. When you jump towards the reflection, actually you will feel as if that because of the commotions you created, you will feel that swan also, the reflection also is jumping on you. When a fish jumps towards the reflection, just because of the very commotion or waves created by the fish will start thinking the reflection is also jumping. Reflection is also hugging me. That fish will write a sentence. This swan is so loving, so caring, so hugging, so blissful. This fish is so great. This fish will write reminiscence. The other fish will jump away from the reflection. The fish which jumps away from the reflection, just because of the very commotion of the waves created, it will feel as if the reflection is moving away. If the fish is moving this side towards the swan, you create a wave because of that you think reflection is hugging you. If you jump this way, you think the reflection is rejecting you. And you create your own concepts and fight. And whole drama goes on. And whole this thing goes on. Suddenly, The sun starts flying on the ground. No more reflection is seen. All these fishes, what happened? We don't know. The sun has left us. What has happened? All those fishes now they will start building a big temple. Where that reflection was seen. They will have a huge temple. Where that reflection was reflecting. Be very clear. Your ashrams, you are fighting, your early senses that reflection is great, loving and caring, or your early senses reflection is rejecting and ignoring me, or your idea that I am close to reflection, I am away from reflection, all this nonsense, the swan doesn't even know. Swan doesn't even know. Let it be very clear, you are playing with reflections. You are playing with reflection and wasting the time and energy. Only few, very few intelligent fishes suddenly start suspecting. This cannot be a fish. This cannot be a homegrown fish. This must be something else. He cannot be a human being. This is something else. Just something else. Those few fishes, intelligent fishes, who suspect this is not ordinary fish, this is not what we think, only those few fishes suddenly raise the hand and lift their head, see the horizon, see the swan fly. Those fishes who have seen the swan fly, they wake up and think, I can also fly, and they start flying. Only those swans will be ever with me. Only they will be with me forever. Only those swans are going to be with me. If at all there is a purpose for the swan to fly at the water, it is the only purpose. Hoping that few fishes may suddenly look up and start flying, remembering that we also have wings. Because we did not fly for a long time, we forgot we can fly. That's the only hope with which the reflection is being reflected on the pond. Either you are thinking that swan is either loving or caring, or you are thinking that swan is rejecting me. I was reading so many letters, so much of love letters. God, I was just shocked. So much of love letters. Be very clear, you are projecting and connecting and seeing. If you have an idea about me, be very clear. You will be cheated very badly. You will be cheated very badly. You will utterly feel hopeless at one day. Because whatever idea you have about me, I will shake from the root. Same day, somebody has written, the moment you see me with so much of hatred, I feel that ground under me should open and swallow me. Let it swallow. Who cares? You are not even worthy of that much hatred. People who see love in my eyes and people who see hatred in my eyes, both of you are hallucinating. Both of you are creating illusions. Connecting and seeing. Both of you are going to suffer. One will suffer after I leave the body. Another will suffer when I am in the body. That's all. See, the fishes which they think I am loving, caring, they will enjoy it in the body. After I leave the body, they will suffer 1,000 times intensely. Or after I, even forget about the question of leaving the body, even if I move to another country, these fishes will suffer. And the fishes who think I am hating, they will suffer when I am around, they will not suffer when I am away. When these fishes are away, they will not suffer. When I am around, they will ignoring whatever idea you create, you are creating. Be very clear. One more thing. Ultimately, only I am consistent. Just now I said I am the most inconsistent person. Now I am telling you, ultimately I will be a consistent person. Because anybody who is stuck in this level can never be consistent. Person who has realized his source. Person who is in this, only he will be consistent. Narayan is asking, the shaft which I am creating, I have no shaft. I am just in this because I am just in this. Only I will be consistent. Be very clear. Looking to yourself, the day you met me, until today, how many ups and downs you have gone, I know. Tell me, how many ups and downs? I know. You are inconsistent. Only I, but whenever you come to me, you will see that I will be same way. I will be the same person. So be very clear. I am the only consistent guy. Because I am the source. I know the things which make you inconsistent are not me. But in your case, you associate yourself with this. And you will be always struggling. I have always seen people, they come and ask me, Swamiji, should I stay with him? Or should I stay inside the ashram? If I tell them stay, immediately they will list all the reasons why they should not stay. I have this problem, I have that problem, I have this, I have that. If I tell them, alright, don't stay, go. Immediately they will list all the things why they should stay. No, then I will miss this, I will miss that. If I take this step, mind will take that step. If I take that step, I will take this step. That is why many times I know this not this step. If I want the fellowship to should stay inside, I tell them, no, better go. It is not for you. You are not that much qualified. Go. Then you will meet ego will be angry. What? How dare you tell? I am not qualified. I prove my qualification. I will stay here. That's what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Because I know how to talk to people. I know how to get the things done. I know how the things can be done. Be very clear. You are not consistent. One more thing. You create shaft and I don't create shaft. Here you are asking. Life of enlightenment seems to be consistent and clutch. First of all, you don't know anything about my life after enlightenment. What you are seeing is not my life. Next thing, it is not clutched. What drives this shaft that you are creating? All other things are life. Because very basic thing when you don't know, how can you create this question? This question itself is useless. The shaft which you create is an illusion. The shaft which I don't create is also an illusion. I don't create a shaft, but you think I create that shaft. That's an illusion. Be very clear. Because you create a shaft, you think I also create a shaft. That's the only thing. That you all will be clear. People come and tell me again and again, Swamiji, I miss you. Swamiji, I miss you. Swamiji, I miss you. And they expect that I should also miss them. Let me be very clear now, I don't even remember you guys' names. When I leave the hall, I don't even remember the names. When I enter into my room and close the room, I first of all don't remember this planet. What about your name? So be very clear. Your idea that I have a shaft is complete foolishness. I don't have a shaft. Because you have a shaft, you think I am also having a shaft. One more thing. This whole mission is running not because of shaft. If I had a shaft long before, I would have become mad. So much at work. because I don't have a short family, so much is happening so smoothly. If the idea of I is just causeless, unconnected thoughts, then what is exactly the real I? When you drop this false I, something will be happening to you is real I. You can't even know what is real I. You can't say, I have thought this, this is the real I. No. The real I doesn't under, it cannot be understood. It doesn't exist in the level in which you can understand. See, when you understand that it's causeless and drop everything, something will be happening to your body. Your body will just move in as characterless. See, as of now you have a character. The character is moving the body. The personality is moving the body. Your body will be moving personality-less. Just being-less. It will be just moving. That is what I call real I. Only then you radiate a special grace. You radiate special grace. Is the idea of being also an illusion? If not, how do we know? Whatever you know as being is illusion. Be very clear. Yesterday, whatever I spoke, if it has created some explosion in you, if you really felt atom bomb, then it's the truth for you. Otherwise, if it has not happened to you, whatever I spoke is also illusion. If you are not caught it. Yesterday, if you felt really calm, what big relief. With which I was fighting, he himself doesn't exist. If you have felt, no, what he says is true, I have to realize that. Again, you are fool, miss the gap. Miss it. That moment I told you to write, when you wrote itself, you understood. It's not. Clutch thoughts. There is no need even to realize. You are unclutched. Truth is there, that's all. There is no need for you to realize. You are unclutched thoughts, over. Uncontrollable. Nothing can be done. That's all, over. There is nothing else needs to be done. If you understood that, on a tremendous inner healing, that relaxation that has happened in you, whatever I spoke is truth. Otherwise, whatever I spoke to you is only lie, knowledge. You have not got it. Even if you have a single problem somewhere, last speck of doubt, somewhere in one corner, you miss it. Again, I have to sit with you. Is God also an illusion? Whatever you know as God is an illusion. Suddenly all of this look like mere concepts. Please explain to clear my understanding. Who is the person that? Always put your names below, because I'll answer it to you exactly. When you say all these things look like mere concepts, what these concepts are, this world? Everything is concept. Be very clear. You talking to Venkateshwara is purely concept. Everything is concept. Purely concept. Be very clear. You talking to your husband is the frequency of 10. 10 frequency. You talking to Venkateshwara is 25 frequency. Little better than this frequency, that's all. It is little better than this frequency. But the ultimate frequency is the only truth. Ultimate frequency is the only truth. All the things. So you talking to Venkateshwara is little better than you talking to your husband. That's all. But it is not truth. Let it be very clear. A lie which is closer to truth. That's all. Nothing more than that. It's like a, you say here is a banyan tree. And you stand in Mysore road, here is a banyan tree. Here is a banyan tree. When you stand in Mysore road and show the hand, here is a banyan tree. And when you stand here and show, here word is little more truth than that word. Am I right? That word is a lie compared to this word, because vanity is more close here. That much only, all your spiritual experiences, be very clear. And straight away telling you the truth, it will shake you. And any of you guys had some spiritual experiences, and it completely shake you. All your vested interests will be taken away. People, especially who are constantly sitting and crying in front of God, or some statue, doing some stotra, some sloka, some mantra, whole thing will be now shaken away. Because whatever you did, doing, whole thing is just little better, that's all. Not truth. I don't want to shake you too much, that's why I use the word little better. It is not even little better, be very clear. It is not even little better. I just don't want to shake you too much. I just want to, I'm a bit compassionate. People can't be alive without lies. That's why I had to use a polished word. It is not even little better. At least with your husband, he will talk to you well. Here you will be doing the both the game. It's just the monodrama. Have you heard that monodrama? The same guy will sit here and talk and sit there and talk. You are doing a well planned monodrama, that's all. Nothing else. All your visions, one more thing I want to tell you, even if you had a vision of me, it's a monodrama. And even if you came and told me, I confirmed, yes, I only gave you darshan. Even without you telling me, if I have told also, all these things are pure monodrama. Because whatever you see is you. Whatever you see is you. Now there are so many confusions raising in the mind. It is good actually. That's why I have 15 days program. So that everything will become clear. When you go, you will be proper. One beautiful Buddhist story. Zen disciple says, before the sun, mountain was mountain, river was river, forest was forest. After the search ended, mountain is mountain, river is river, forest is forest. At the time of search, mountain is not mountain, river is not river, forest is not forest. Because the whole thing will be confused at the time of search, the transition. This 15 days will be a transition period for you. That's why I kept 15 days program. Let you completely move from this base to the original truth. Be very clear. Whatever you heard, whatever you saw, whatever you felt, whole thing is pure illusion. You are connecting it and seeing. You are connecting it and seeing. That is the reason I don't do this type of magic. If I take like this and give you, that itself is an illusion. And if I bring and give you, that's one more illusion. I do not want to supply you with illusions. I want you to be awakened from this basic illusion that this exists. These people ask me, why don't you utilize the Buddhist give this one? I tell them, if I take it from plate and give you, that itself is an illusion. Because there is neither vibhuti, nor me, nor you. All three are illusion. If I take from the hand and if I materialize and give you, that's one more illusion, that's all. Nothing else. The only truth is, stop connecting and seeing. Then you may ask, what will I see? What will happen to me? Let everything happen, be calm. Let this truth penetrate you. Let you be completely broken by this truth. Let this truth work on you. If you are scared, one door is open backside. All these look like mere concepts, including me. Whatever you know as me is a mere concept. Be very clear. Today, if you have a concept, I am very loving, caring, you will be jumping around me. tomorrow you will suddenly get the concept that I am not loving and caring, you will be against me. That's all. I always tell you, people who touch their feet, any moment they will pull the leg. Be careful. Don't think they are touching the feet out of respect. Any moment they will pull the leg. Because it's purely their concept. It's purely their concept. It is purely your illusion. You cannot believe a man who is an illusion. That is why sometimes people who are too much surrendering, loving, caring, running away in my form, I will keep them away. Because they are running because of their illusions. The moment I keep them, the whole thing will become accurate. May not be directly accurate because they will have good fear. How can I get him? And they will console themselves. Even though he ignores me, he takes care of me, he has got love and compassion for me. You cheating, be very clear. I have no love for you. I don't care for you. I have no love for you, I don't care for you. Even if you go to dogs, I have no problem. Because you are already dark, nothing. There is no need to go to dogs. I don't care for you. Your idea that I love you is a pure illusion. Then you create tomorrow the same idea. That I hate you. As long as you are living in illusion, you are dangerous species. You are? Dangerous person. Anybody who is in illusion, even surrender out of illusion is dangerous. That is why sometimes I am afraid of people surrender. These guys, when they come and try to surrender, I will just take myself away. I'm running away. Because it is out of illusion. Connecting and seeing. Any connection and seeing is pure illusion. Pure illusion. All your thoughts, connections, the whole thing is just nonsense. Be very clear. You are unclutched, unconnected, illogical, independent, uncontrollable thoughts. There is no linear connection between thought and thought. There is only vertical connection. You go back to the source, from the same source the next thought rises. That's all. You start creating linear connections, the sin has started. You have started the bondage. Then, see, between this thought and this thought, there cannot be any linear connection. Only vertical connection, you have to come back and go. Because you don't have so much of time, you start thinking, you start connecting in this way. There is no linear connection between thought and thought. Every time you come back to Anandaganda, your being, and next thought raises. Your thoughts has no linear connection. From where the thoughts are raising are coming. Understand your thoughts are unconnected. Then automatically you will drop to the, you will realize the source. You don't have to start thinking from where it is coming, who am I, from where the thoughts are raising, all this nonsense. You don't need to do all this nonsense. Just understand you are unconnected. That's enough. That is enough. There is no need for you to think who am I and all those things. That and all is sadhana. Here I am. I am not going to give any technique to the planet Earth. Straight away, sadhana and sadhya is one and the same. Path and goal is one and the same. Now, just now, that's all. Do not postpone by this question, who is Anandayagarati? Missed what I spoke yesterday. Understand you are unclutched. That's enough. Nothing. The moment you understand you are unclutched, automatically you will be the source of thought. That's all. The moment you don't make a linear connection, you will simply fall into the vertical connection, the vertical source. Because you are creating the linear connections itself, you never come to the source. The moment you stop the linear connecting activity, simply you slip into the source. One more thing, now for the understanding sake, I make the vertical diagram call. There are no linear, no vertical. Just that's all. If a person misunderstands me, always nag by telling the old happenings, how to handle the situation, be very clear. That idea you have, that you always tells the old happenings and nags you, is your idea. You are constantly connecting it and seeing. There are so many thousands of things that happened between. So many things you would have spoken, other things would have happened between you and him. Why are you forgetting all those things and connecting only these things and seeing? I 50 to 70% keep quiet, sometimes get angry. Who this person? Your idea that you get angry is one more connection and seeing. 50 to 70% I keep quiet is one more connecting and seeing. How will you put a percentage? First of all, where is the percentage? Then you think 10 times you spoke like this. 5 times I shouted back. 5 times I did not. Connecting and seeing. The whole illusion. People have not only created illusion, they created illusions about illusions. It has gone in multiplication level. It has gone in multiplication level. I am confused about the context in which we can apply this truth about illusions that you mentioned. No context. In all contexts, this is the truth. Don't think you will have this as a weapon and apply it wherever you want, and you will not apply it and keep it wherever you want. This is a naked truth. If you apply or not, who cares? You suffer, that's all. If you understand, you are liberated this moment and enjoy. If you don't understand, suffer, that's all. There is no context.